just wishing you a gorgeous day.
Things keep getting better.
He's the queer eye grooming expert responsible for making over looks and lives on the hit series that pulls on all the heartstrings.
Try not to cry, try not to lose it.
You've literally saved people's lives, mine included.
All while being his Jonathan Van Ness authentic self. Now he's ready to share his lifelong obsession with us all.
I have been watching figure skating like it was the end of the world since 1992.
With Olympic-sized aspirations, Jonathan's got Beijing 2022 in his sights and has skated into Oz with his live show called Road to Beijing.
Never gonna get these jumps together in time for my tour
of Australia, honey.
Well, joining us from Brisbane, please welcome Jonathan Van Ness. Degrees there in Brisbane today, quite tropical. How's the hair going?
I'm sporting curls, as you can see. I'm embracing all of the humidity up in here.
It's working for you. Don't worry about that.
Jonathan, you're in Australia on your Road to Beijing tour. I'm fascinated. Are you going to Beijing as a spectator or a competitor?
Well, you know, I think it's going to depend on where we end up in ending up with, you know, United States figure skating. Obviously, I can't do any double jumps yet, and I certainly can't do very many ice dance moves to qualify for the team. So it's not looking good, but probably spectator. Fingers crossed.
I have to say, I've been a spectator on your Instagram watching you learn ice skating, and I used to ice skate as a kid, and I have actually booked in ice skating lessons again. I'm going in 2 weeks because of your Instagram. Watching you has inspired me to go back.
That's amazing. Thank you so much. I'm so excited that you're going to get back into it. I mean, I've, you know, obviously loved figure skating my entire life. I just started last year, and there's nothing like that feeling.
Your live show, though, I am very interested in, because I've heard there's gymnastics in it. Can you explain exactly how this happens and how you just seamlessly weave it into a stand-up show?
Totally. I did my first tour in the summer of 2018, and on one of those shows, I had not had 2 beers, and I did not decide to just throw a standing back handspring to make sure that I could still do one on stage.
Sure.
I didn't mean to plan it, but it just happened. And after I did this back handspring on stage, which, you know, as a cheerleader in high school, I, you know, was really into gymnastics growing up, I was like, oh my gosh, if I, you know, work in a gymnastics routine into this show, like, what are they gonna do, get up and leave? I'm pretty sure it would work. And so I kind of just started, like, workshopping a full-on floor routine already in that tour, and I've just kind of kept going. So I think it's like really fun to just throw on a leotard and like spice it up a notch. I feel like I don't know if there's really been that many stand-up comedian acts who bring out a gigantic tumble track and put a 32-year-old full grown-up person who's not a professional gymnast or a Cirque du Soleil person by any means. And, you know, is it me healing the wounds of my inner 6-year-old child whose, like, father wouldn't watch them do routines? Maybe. But it's a really good time.
Do you ever get hecklers at your live shows, Jonathan?
The only time I ever really had a heckler was this one time when I accidentally called Ireland the United Kingdom.
Oh,
just
no.
A slip of the tongue.
Oh,
and that was the only time. I honestly, it was right in the opening. It was actually right after the gymnastics. And then I bring out the opener to do like their, you know, 10-minute set while I'm changing. And I literally had to call my mom in the back room because we're part Irish, honey. We're also part English. And I was like, Mom, I literally just got booed for the first time. I miss nationality to Ireland. And she was like, get back out there, apologize. They will sort it out. So I went back out and I was like, I am so sorry. Like, my heart is, you know, in my, I don't know if I can say that on this TV show, but I, you know, I could say it that night. And I just said, my heart is somewhere down here and I'm so sorry. And they forgave me and it all worked out. But typically I don't have hecklers.
Well, last year you released your book, Over the Top, A Raw Journey to Self-Love. And it was you opening up a lot about testing positive to HIV and struggling with drug addiction. How is your journey to self-love going?
It's good. Well, you know, I think everyone is always on a journey to self-love and self-acceptance. I think that that's like, you know, unfortunately, I think we can't really be like, ah, got it, moving on now. So I think it's a continued relationship that I think that we're all in our own, you know, kind of relationship with ourselves. So I think usually it's really pretty good. I think I have a really strong support system around me. You know, my cats really help. My friends and family really help. And I also think that it's really just kind of about you know, building in that time for you to connect with yourself, whether that's like your passion or whether that's your yoga or your, you know, your quiet time, whatever it is you need to kind of feel like, I try to be good about incorporating that in my schedule so I stay like on the up and up in the self-love game.
Jonathan, back home, you have publicly endorsed Elizabeth Warren as your next president. As a celebrity, it can be controversial to put your head on the block, if you like, and back somebody in. We saw Taylor Swift in her latest documentary kind of agonizing over a tweet. Did you consider the blowback that you might get over that?
No, I think, you know, I've since Queer Eye has started, I've always been very like vocal about, you know, what I'm curious about, what I'm learning about, what I think. I think that's part of trying to be visible and, you know, trying to ask questions, I think is a really important part about, you know, about having this platform. And so, no, I think I didn't really consider the blowback that I would have. And I also think that, you know, as someone living with HIV in a country where, you know, healthcare is not a human right, I thought this is really the candidate who I feel like can really be a leader and legislate and get things done in Washington, D.C., where we really need these changes to happen so that we can experience the change I think, you know, our country needs. And also, I would just add, if there's any Americans watching in here in gorgeous Australia, head to ElizabethWarren.com. Honey, chip in what you can. She just got off the debate stage. She did so well. She nailed this debate tonight. She did so good. I'm like, yes, Elizabeth, yes. She was just, I'm screaming in this venue. But yeah, she was really good. She did so good.
Now, Jonathan, I understand you spent today at a koala sanctuary. How was that?
It was incredible. I mean, Australia has the most amazing, like, wildlife here. I nearly got a nose kiss from Connery, who I was holding today.
First name basis. We won't deter you with the chlamydia. We'll just let you discover all that by yourself.
Hey, I already learned about the koala chlamydia there, and she was telling me at the place, it's one thing to joke about chlamydia and koalas, but you have to remember, this is a fatal disease for koalas. So it's funny, but it's also like, honey, we got to get this vaccine together, which that Lone Star Koala Sanctuary is doing. They're helping with the vaccination, so that's amazing.
Oh. Details on where you can catch Jonathan on his Road to Beijing tour on our website. In the meantime, would you please thank Jonathan Van Ness?
Thank you for having me, everyone, so much.
I love him so much.